I'm going to be reading some of the listener emails. And today we're going to kick off that segment, starting with this email from Brian Demkoski in New Hampshire. So glad you started the podcast. Thank you, Brian. Looking forward to it growing and developing. Me too. To that end, is there anything we, your listeners in the Garmy, can do to help you out production-wise? I remember Babylon really got going when folks started sending in jingles and such. Is there anything you need? Jingles, sound bites, or anything for the website? Sincerely yours, Brian in New Hampshire. What a generous offer and very kind of you. Actually, yes, you know what I could use? A jingle for this segment. I could use an intro for our weekly listener email segment. So if you have an idea, Brian, work it up, send it on in. Or anybody else who has an idea for a jingle, an opening intro jingle for this segment, the listener emails, that'd be great. I opened up the door and said, if you got an idea for a jingle for the segment, send it all in to consider. Mike Serber sent this one in. I like it a lot. It's kind of a spoof on a classic rock song. I dig it.
Don't need no tickets for an aeroplane to find out what's on my listeners' brains. Time to say hello to the folks at home. The Garmy wrote me some letters.
That's from Mike Serber. Thanks so much, Mike. Well, we've been playing a game here called What's Up Nick Nolte's Ass. And Steve Barden, legendary music composer for television and film, Steve Barden, who, by the way, wrote the original music for the Showbiz Beat. Thank you, Steve. I didn't get a chance to thank you publicly for that, but thanks so much for sending that in. He has also contributed a little jingle for this new segment that's just kind of popped out of Nick Nolte's ass.
What's up, what's up? What's up?
Thank you, Steve Barden. For it is Friday, June 22nd. Here are your holidays for the day. We do need a jingle for this or something.
We do. We need a jingle.
Yeah. Again, we're reaching out. If you're a member of the Garmy and you're musically inclined at all and you want to come up with a name and or a jingle for this segment, feel free. But now I've got an extra thank you to send out to John Kupperman. John sent in this email. He says, "Hi, Ralph. Been a listener since day one of the Ralph Report. I thought you would like this. It is a theme for holiday or holiday.
Ah.
Love the show. Love the vice host. Here's the thing. John does not have any musical
talent.
Ability, as far as I can tell. So it may not be our long-term solution to a theme for this segment.
Stopgap, that's fine.
But at least it's a temporary fix. And now we have a segment, a jingle rather, for this segment, Holiday or Holiday. Here is a member of the Garmy, John Kupperman.
Holiday. Oh, holiday.
What the fuck was that?
There you go. That's spectacular, John. Good for you. You got a future in this business, kid. And now people are trying to send in their jingles for the segment as well.
Yeah, this is exciting.
Marshall Carr has sent us in a new intro. He's suggesting we change it to this.
Hey, kids, do you know today's a national holiday?
Is it Thanksgiving? Is it Christmas?
No, it's actually national... Never mind. More like holiday.
It's a little sketch.
It's like sketch. It's like a whole little one-act play.
It was a little... Had a beginning, a middle, and an end. It was...
Marshall, it was well done. We appreciate your participating. But it's not quite a jingle. That's not something you'd want to play every day in front of a segment.
I liked it, but yeah, you wouldn't want to intro a segment with it. But the kids had a great sense of wonder to their voice.
Kids are great.
Very great actors.
It was a great little piece.
Yeah.
I thought it was well produced, well cast, well written, well performed. Just saying, I can't see us playing it every day.
Yeah.
And John is now starting to augment his own work. He sent in a new version.
He remixed his own intro.
This time with a little musical backup. But he hasn't changed any of the original sort of sad beatbox voice music that he created either, which makes for even, it gets even better when you double it up. And he put an actual fade at the end.
But he actually faded out.
He really tarted that up, and I think...
Because it would have worked fine if he had the music and then just the holiday, holiday, but he
but
kept
with...
He kept
with...
Told you. It's even better. Woo! This holiday or holiday thing is taking on a life of its own. People are obsessed with this.
It's huge.
And now, it's a little late now, the jingles are starting to roll in. The holiday or holiday jingles. I think we're kind of in love with the one we got. And our good friend Anthony Moreno, he sent this one in. And I gotta say, it might be too good for us, I think. Well, that's the problem.
Let's hear it.
And again, it's so well sung and produced, and it's I don't know. Tell me what you think. I think it's too good for us. Here you go.
Holiday or holiday, please tell me what we celebrate. Ralph Garman.
Wow.
Right?
That's impressive.
Too good for us,
yeah,
I
think. Yeah, that's a whole barbershop quartet
little thing going. High-end professional harmonies and musicality, and it sounds like a song.
That's really good.
You know what sounds to me like a... like a song that Robin Hood's Merry Men would be singing in the forest or something.
In the
something.
Forest, as they're stealing gold and slashing the throats of sheriffs of Nottingham.
Beautiful. It's beautifully done. Don't get me wrong. There's nothing wrong at all with what Anthony did. It's beautiful.
It's better than the segment. That's the problem.
I think that is the problem. I think it makes us pale in comparison.
We can't live up to that theme song every day.
But John Cooperman's is just as janky as this segment is. And so I think it's a better fit. So Anthony, thanks so much for your hard work. But we're gonna have to pass at this point. Do you know John Cooperman?
Oh, yeah.
Cooperman.
Like Superman with a K.
Like Superman with a K. He is responsible for our holiday or holiday theme song. Well, you'll be happy to know, Eddie, that you inspired him to once again take pen to paper and create a new theme song.
I'm inspiring creative people all over the place.
John Cooperman hopes we'll start a new segment where I will force feed you different things that you don't like to eat and then gauge your reaction to them. His idea for the segment is called Stuff It.
That's a great idea.
Or horrible. Just eat it. You can pick either one. Here's his theme song.
Stuff it. Please stuff that food in Eddie's mouth. That's what this segment is. Please throw that food down Eddie's mouth. Just eat it.
Yeah.
That's I'm kind of speechless on that one.
That's
I don't
disturbing
know.
Disturbing on so many levels.
Stuff it and eat it and put it in my mouth.
And I said, if you have an idea for a Ziggy jingle, please send it along. And Dan Bauman sent this one in.
Ziggy's terrible.
Right? That's amazing. It's short and it's perfect. Ziggy's terrible from Dan Bauman.
Oh.
Bobby was the guy who initially came up with the idea of us going through the origins of common sayings. Remember we did last week, Down to the Wire.
Down to the Wire. And, yeah.
This was Robert's idea, and we talked about it last week, and he was so thrilled with the fact that we took his idea and made a segment out of it. He actually sent in a theme song for the segment, and has named it Where Did It Come From, is the name of the segment, and this is the song, and I think this is going to stick.
Where did it come from? Where did it go? Where did it come from? We want to know. Where did it come from? Say it ain't so. Where did it come from? Now fucking we'll know.
Where did it come from?
You got a lot of talented fans.
This is the best thing about this job is I sit back and let everyone else the work.
You have so many talented fans.
People come up with the ideas for segments. They name the segments. They come up with the theme songs for the segments. That was by Rick Lee, who's a friend of Bobby Gibson's. They worked on that together, and they sent that in. So we have a new segment now called Where Did It Come From?
Ralph, it's Brian from Mesa, Arizona. What the hell, man? I emailed you weeks ago about that segment for Where Sayings Came From and sent a theme song. And someone else is getting credit? What the hell, man? Anyway, talk to you later. Bye.
All right. And let it be known now from far and wide throughout the kingdom that Brian Scheidecker was, in fact, the first person to recommend The Origins of Idioms was the name of his segment. Not nearly as catchy as Where Did It Come From. And regarding your jingle, Brian, I do remember vividly getting your jingle.
Ralph Garman, tell us the genesis of these idioms. Oh yeah. Oh, tell
out. Brian, nice try, my man. You cannot be angry at me for not using your jingle.
Oh, my God. Even flow is never going to sound the same.
Here's some that I found. It's time to take a look at the letters.
Listen, do-da-do. Ralph is going to read some emails. Do-da-do. Emails.
I haven't played that one in a
that
while.
That was nice. That I didn't know good. We had that.
Yeah, I got it. Had it tucked away, and I was like, I should do that next time I read some emails. I want to thank Dan Wright. He sent in an email. Hey, Ralph, I'm a voiceover artist. A mock movie trailer for The Ralph Report. Hope you guys like it.
Ralph Garman is a man who has swung harder than you can possibly imagine.
Shh, my wife's here tonight.
Always the bull, never the cuck. Eddie Pence is a man who has the palate of a 12-year-old.
I had a fortune cookie today.
Together, they bring you The Ralph Report.
How great is that?
That's amazing.
How talented is that, dude? So I thought we'd play a fun little game. Who'd Ralph play?
Who'd Ralph play? Who'd Ralph play?
Yeah. Nope, nobody gave us a jingle for that
Did
one.
Did you do that?
This was a last minute slap together. That's a placeholder. Now taking submissions.
That stays forever.
For a new title and new jingle for that
perfect.
Segment. Bye. Game is called Small Canadian Town or Sex Term. Small Canadian Town or Sex Term. And I wish I had an intro jingle for this. But I want to thank Anthony Moreno, who took it upon himself to come up with a jingle for a small Canadian town or sex term.
Small Canadian town or sex term. Help us, Ralph. I know you won't let us down. Even if Eddie gets it wrong.
All right. There you go. Several listeners have proposed that we need a jingle for the voicemail section of the show. That
makes sense.
Because we are doing it pretty much every day now because you folks keep filling up the mailbox. This one came from Mitchell Brinkley III. And Mitchell took a song from Book of Mormon and did a parody for the Ralph Report theme song. And I gotta say, I think this one has a lot of potential.
Hi, Ralph. I am your loyal fan, and I have information that I think will help your show. Your show is nice. I need advice. And Eddie Jesus Christ. Hi, Ralph.
Come on, isn't that charming?
It's almost Porky Pig-like.
Yeah, almost. Mike Serber has come up with this one. I don't know. This might have just taken the lead. What do you think?
Call me, I'm Ralph. It's the number everyone's talking about. Call me right now at 1-833. Hi, Ralph.
I don't know. That's pretty good.
That's going to be hard to beat.
Yeah,
that's
pretty good,
that's
Mike.
That's pretty good.
I think you're the jingle to beat.
1-833-HI-RALPH. 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 1-833-HI-RALPH.
Yeah, LMB. I don't think she's cute.
People are going to hurt themselves trying to do that high.
I know. Look, I'm a professional. Please don't try this at home. John Cooperman. Does that name ring a bell for you?
That's
at all?
Our holiday guy, right? Holiday.
John Cooperman is the guy who created, you're absolutely right, Eddie, the holiday or holiday theme song that has just, it lives in the hearts. It lives in the hearts of all the members of
it's
the
It's a one-hit one.
Well, we'll see, because he did come up with a jingle for this segment, for the hotline phone call message segment. And he may, in fact, be a one-hit wonder. It may have been lightning in a bottle the first time around. He's trying to recapture, I think, the flavor of his first hit.
Today, Ralph Garman will play some messages from 1-833-HI-RALPH. All you have to do is pick up your phone
or Skype
and leave a message at the tone, and Ralph Garman will play all of your messages on the Ralph Report. Ooh, ooh, ooh. 1-833-HI-RALPH. Ooh, ooh. And Eddie too. 1-833-HI-RALPH.
It's not bad. That's good.
It's not bad.
A little long, but
it is
good.
14 minutes
it's
long.
A little long.
Here is the newest possible jingle for this voicemail segment.
The telephone is ringing. The garbage's on the line. Ralph's gonna play your calls now and see what's on your mind.
That's pretty good,
I like it,
right?
I like it.
That's pretty like grungy and gritty.
It's hard rockish.
Yeah, I like that one.
Hi, Ralph. So every time you play, Ralph got him all no. I always hear a bullwhip. You need a bullwhip. LMB. Bye.
She thinks we need a bullwhip for that jingle. And, you know, the more I thought about
always,
it.
You could always use a bullwhip.
Everything's better with a bullwhip.
It really is. It really is. Yeah, it's
that
so much
sound
better.
Makes everything better.
It's the exclamation point in life, really.
All the time. First of all, I need to just have it at the ready in case anything comes up that needs just emphasis. But also, when I think of that jingle, where did it come from? I thought, God damn it, she's right. That could use a bullwhip at the end of it. So please enjoy the new and improved version of Where Did It Come From?
Where did it come from? Where did it go? Where did it come from? We want to know. Where did it come from? Say it ain't so. Where did it come from? Ralph Martin will know.
Oh.
Right?
Perfect.
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 John did, in fact, take another attempt at Garmy fame. He sent in a jingle for the Dream Interpretation segment, which we're about to do. But John thought he had a take on a segment jingle for Dream Interpretation.
Gotta keep slugging away.
So, look, we'll give the kid a shot. Right here. Here we go.
Hey, Ralph. Hey, Ralph. The dream. What did it mean, Ralph? Hey, Ralph. The dream.
Look, I get it, John. Just saying. Holiday and Holiday might have been lightning in a bottle. We have a new intro, by the way. Seth Berry sent this in. He said, I threw this together. It's short and sweet. See what you think.
Eddie's terrible.
Right?
Where did you make that one?
That was a new one. That was sent
God
in to us this
it.
Week. People keep sending in. You want to hear some other ones?
Like, sure.
This is a new one, too.
Eddie, what have you done for me lately?
Yeah, that's a new one. We got a couple of them. Yeah. Now, Eddie loves my theme song for this because I did it myself in a rush. And it basically goes, ooh, Ralph play.
Oh, get a live performance.
Yes, because we have a new one, which I think may be better than mine. We'll have to let people decide.
All right.
But this one is coming from a guy with talent who also does a Peter Griffin impression.
Oh.
And he put together this new intro for the segment.
Who did he play? Ralph Garman voiced a tune today. What line did he say? It's time to play your favorite game, cause who'd Ralph Garman play on Family Guy?
What do you think?
That's pretty great.
It's pretty good,
that's pretty
right?
Great.
So I do want to mention Chris Wilk is the genius behind the new Who'd Ralph Play jingle. It's only about a minute long. Here's Rosie Galindo singing, You've Got My Patreon.
There's a show I really love to hear. Keeps me entertained while I drive around here. You listen to Ralph Garman and that other guy who doesn't like real food and keeps me asking why. The show is awesome. I really love it and I can listen to it every single day. The show is awesome. I really love it. Every day I want to listen to it all on Showbiz Beat. You have my Patreon and it's real entertaining to listen to it all on Showbiz Beat. You have my Patreon and I play it on the street.
Come on.
Wow.
How about that voice?
Wow.
How about if you were able to open your mouth and that sound came out?
Wow.
Holiday.
holiday or holiday, please tell us what we celebrate. Ralph Garman.
Hi, Ralph. This is Lauren from Corona. My 10-year-old wants to sing you his new Ralph Report song that he just made up.
All I want to hear is the Ralph Report. The Ralph Report. The Ralph Report. All I want to hear is the Ralph Report for the week.
And we've got a new jingle in the new year for this segment, so we'll see if it sticks around or not.
Oh, yeah, I don't know something. I just don't understand. So I need to ask someone, perhaps an Englishman. I want to ask a Brit. I want to ask a Brit.
Hey Ralph, it's Alfonso, 4-star general. Hey man, I don't know if you notice this, but I notice this every single time you play the EDM song, the Where Did It Come From. But is that cowbell off? Let me know if you agree. Thanks, Ralph. Love you. Mean it. Bye.
A lot of people have complained about this, saying at the start of the intro, the cowbell that's keeping time is off with the rhythm of the rest of the songs. It seems to catch up by the time the vocals kick in. So listen to this new version and see if everyone can relax and enjoy it.
Where did it come from? Where did it go? Where did it come from? We want to know. Where did it come from? Say it ain't so. Where did it come from? Our farming mill, no.
So that works, right?
Yeah, it catches up by that point.
Yeah, by then we're good. Cardigan Backyardigan is in the news this week. She released on Instagram a confessional from the backseat of her limo. Her pants were so tight, in her words, not mine, her pussy couldn't breathe.
Jesus Christ.
So she pulled her pants down, bare-ass naked in the backseat of the limo, and then proceeded to do a confessional into the camera that she posted on Instagram about why she was riding in the backseat. Bare ass.
This I gotta ride in the car, son, because these pants is too motherfucking tight. She was giving my pussy a wedgie. I hate having pussy wedgies, bro. My pussy be screaming at me like, bitch, you got me fucked up. You want a yeast infection, bitch? You want a fucking yeast infection? So you know what I'm saying? Gotta ride around this hole like this. Pussy breathing, though. Pussy breathing!
that worked well there.
I think she's got the lyrics to her next hit, quite frankly.
Pussy breathing.
Pussy breathing absolutely would be a smash hit if she would just put a beat behind that and just record it. Pussy breathing. Pussy breathing. This next one comes from Trevor Field. Trevor, you are the Garmy citizen of the day, and you will see why in a moment. Ralph, I thought you might want to hear this clip I found from Cardi B's new single. Here is the clip that Trevor sent in of the brand new Cardi B single. I believe it's called Pussy Breathing.
Pussy Breathing! Pussy Breathing! You want a yeast infection, bitch? Pussy Breathing! You got me fucked up. Pussy Breathing, bitch!
Come on! How great is that?
You want a yeast infection?
I want a long version of that, Trevor.